from Baby Bagel Ham. Whew. I tried a new opening today. It didn't work that well. I'll watch it again on the replay. I thought it was funny, though. I had that book over there because I was actually reading today. So I was like, oh, I should try a corny opening. It was going to be a great intro. I have to practice something again, and I'll eventually come up with something a little bit better in the future. My pedal actually worked pretty well for that. Let me move that back over here. We are here for that sweet, sweet mana booty, though. Let's push that there. So anyway, so how's everyone doing? How's everyone's Thursday? Might as well stay standing, sir. Oh, come on. You know, fair enough. Fair enough. Next time you should spin around. It is Little Friday. Oh, does Sora want to see some of that mana booty? This mana booty?
Konnichiwa!
Oh, hello. Thank you, Elder. I'm actually thinking about doing a new, hello, Mr. Pout. Wink. Double wink. Or is a double wink more like just a blink? Wink, wink, blink. There we go. I'm playing around with Sora's a booty connoisseur, from what I under. Well then, Sora is a booty connoisseur. So if you need your booty being rated, go ahead and send a whisper over to Sora. Please don't, or do. I don't. She might like it. Who knows? But we're gonna be maybe doing something. A raffle. I'm thinking of doing a raffle for some of my old keyboards that I have lying around. And doing something with channel points for it. I gotta work on the logistics of that. Everyone DM Sora booty pics. Sorry, Sora? Are they beige keyboards? Let's see a look. So I got this one. What is this? It's a Keychron. It's K8C2, and it's got those blue clicky boys. It is a keyboard, but I've got like a bunch of keyboards that I hardly ever use, and I was like, you know what? That could be fun doing like a raffle or something. I don't know. Getting rid of them. Slowly but surely. But Keychron, yeah, I have box whites in mine. Yeah, you do. Yeah, I've been using this, what have I been using? What is this? A Glorious PC Gaming Race. It's a wired keyboard. It actually works very good. But I switched to the, those sexy browns. Can't hear that. Can't hear it. Can't hear it. No clickies. It is also a keyboard. Jeez. Raffle, I hardly know. That doesn't work as well as the other ones. Hey, let's go. I prefer the clack. You do prefer the clack. I used to prefer the clack. And then I started being on like a lot of conference calls and stuff at work. And I want to not be muted. And I also want to be able to not pay attention effectively and do other work. So I've switched to stealthier options. Who's got the clack? Elder's got the clack. Who's got the clack? Elder's got the clack. Clickety clack. I don't... That's awesome. Let's start off Fallout. Let's get this going before... Any other weird things happen. I'm not saying you got the clap, dude. The clack is like the, is similar to the clap, but not. I got nothing. This got awkward fast. Oh, I gotta lower the resolution of my monitor first. Hold on. Because the max resolution on... today. Let's see. And I didn't move a lot with my feet because I have a history of tripping myself. And I really, really don't want to fall on stream. That is a personal goal of mine. It really is. Let's see. What's the max resolution on this honky-tonk? 2560 by 1440. That's lame. But we got that going. Let's play this game. Alright, so let's see. I only have 200 now, and I'm gonna have to save so I can make you stand next. Razor Green Mechanicals? I'm gonna start doing keyboard ASMR. Nice. The clack. Sweet. So now I know that Elder has been neutralized. She's no longer a threat. Let's see. Looking for a game to capture? Yeah, no you're not. The reason is to... Elder Calf is jittery today? Why is it? Were you drinking a lot of coffee? Were you drinking lots of coffee, or is it the clack? The clack is known to cause people to have the jitters. Hey. All I know is that somebody here enabled sound alerts. And I don't regret a thing. It was great. It's better than the first song I ever got scared with alerts. I think I, like, did the arm flail and everything. So you did better. Oh, both of us got you. Nice. Where did we leave off on our tour? Oh, hey, what's up, girl? Oh, we're at Rivet City. Okay, sweet. Well, first I actually got like a snack box from work for, Employee Appreciation Day that is tomorrow, and they wanted to say that we appreciate you, which I thought was kind of nice. And I love snacks, as we all know. And one of the things I wanted to try today on stream, other than the I'm going to be trying some ketchup potato chips from our friends in Canada, it's this little... Let me go back to chatting. It's this little chocolate called... What are these? Right? Pocket Latte. It's a caffeinated chocolate bar. Yeah. Let me get the actual box up. I hate like half of the box already. So, clean up some of these. Where is this from? So they got me... Let's see. Yeah, they got me the Crave Box care package. Which is really, really sweet. Lay's ketchup potato chips? I don't know if those are the proper Canadian potato chips. But there's, you know it's legit when there's Stroop waffles. Stroop waffles are legit. There's a lot of ZZ's stuff in here. That's like usually a like child's brand. It's like a lot of nut allergy safe stuff. This is going to be interesting. It's a toasted corn cracker guava. I'm spoiled. I am very spoiled. So I'm gonna enjoy some caffeinated chocolate morning on stream while this cow or this Brahmin moves to us. Stroopwafel. Let's see here. Brahmin ASMR. Instead, they send grief. So funny that they call it Brahmin, because Brahmin, so in India, in the Hindu culture specifically, Brahmin is the highest caste in the caste system that was still there, the caste system. And it's funny that the two-headed cow is called Brahmin, which are holy-like. But, oh, look at this!
Hey.
Hey, what up? So each of these, it's like a quarter of a cup of coffee per like square. So let's take.
What flavor is this?
Cream and sugar? Yeah. That does taste like coffee. That is just solid coffee. Yeah, it's just coffee. Nothing special. I get error messages and told to do better.
Hey there.
Okay. So where do we kind of... Yeah, this bar is not that good. I would not pay for it. If you ever see Pocket Latte, don't buy it. Unless you need like caffeine emergency. Not that good. Okay. Where are we? So we're right outside of Rivet City, which is actually an aircraft carrier. Isn't that cool? And there's the Jefferson Memorial. Yes. Yes, I know exactly what you're talking about, Elder.
Good to see you.
The owl one actually tastes like chocolate. And Yaka, you're exactly right. I would have probably done better just chewing the coffee grounds. Yeah, that was pretty bad. Wait, you were... Oh, that is the worst. I am a big believer if you cook... Like, you are in the food service industry. Like, you're serving people food. You get a meal at work. Like, that's how it should work. As you are guaranteed a meal per shift. Done. Lay's ketchup chips? Okay, good. They are one of the good brands. Okay. So, a fun fact, fact. Of this game is that there's always these guys laying around the major settlements. Where is this honky? Oh yeah, you do need some Tim Tams in your life. There's always these guys lying around outside of settlements. He must not be here yet. But if you ever need your karma to like go up, there's these guys outside of settlements who are like, oh, I need some water. So you just give them a bottle of clean water, and they're like, oh, man, thank you, bruh. Oh, there he is. I mean, look at this
dude.
Please,
do you have any water? I'm so thirsty.
Oh, find your own water. Get fucked.
I understand.
So you're in a nursing home, and they didn't just even...
leave me.
What? That's crazy, man. So that's crazy. Because, like, it's in mass quantities. Well, I hope you don't work there anymore, because that place sounds like it's terrible.
Please help me.
But good karma, who needs that?
Welcome to Rivet City. Please wait while the bridge extends.
You know what else is extending? Oh my goodness! Strider Knight! Oh, what's it? All I do is win, no matter what. Strider's in the house. Dancing. And then they go down.
Hold it right there.
Oh, you hold it
State
right there.
State your business in Rivet City.
State my business? I'm looking for Dr. Lee, what up?
Yeah? Let me guess. No, she's not expecting you. But it's really important, and you need to see her right away.
Yeah.
Been a lot of that going around lately, and I've had just about enough of it. So you're going to have to do better than that.
Yeah, how about you get fucked? Can I tell him that? Nope. Alright, hey, it's no big deal.
Fine, just don't bother her. She's real busy with all her work. She's up in the science lab. Carry on then.
Yeah. Get.
There was some sort of battle
hey.
In the city yesterday.
Hey. Hey.
The gate guards
hey.
Said the gunfire went on
Fuck
for
you.
Over an hour.
That's why I'm glad I'm in here.
Bernie Bongos. Oh yeah, I'm addicted to some drugs, so I need like a doctor to like just cure me of my drugs. What up?
This is a quick fix. I mean, that's the name of our shop. Polly and mine, that is. My name is Cindy. Cindy Cantelli.
Don't bother her. This is exactly where she is. Don't you dare bother her, though. This is her schedule as well, and her pager number, and the key to her house.
We've got all kinds of chems.
Oh, did some extra training. Oh, nice. Wait, I need you to, like, no. Scroll's already killing me. Gotta get over here. Hold on. Contact. I thought the extra monitor was gonna solve this problem. It has not solved this problem. You're seeing it in action how it's not working for me. Right. It's a little bit better. It's a little bit better than having the split screen, but
I'm
So I had this one buddy at work, so I'm a programmer, and because we're always up for the memes. The joke is, if you have a vertical monitor while you're programming, that means you, like, you're that much better at programming. Like, if you have a dark theme for your text editor and it's on a vertical monitor, shit, you might as well just be, like, you wrote the book on it. So my buddy at work got three monitors and put them vertical, all three of them vertical. And he's like,
yeah, Bell's going to have.
Obviously my code is the most badass available because I have three vertical monitors, and I was like, I can't argue with that logic. It is pretty.
I'll be right with you.
Pretty solid. What's up, Boo? I don't want to talk to you. I want to talk to the good doctor. Ooh, actually, I need to go to. He's the master of code, exactly.
Tamper with that, and we're going to have a problem.
Dude, Sydney, chill the fuck out. Put your gun away. I mean, look at this lady. She's got her gun out. It's like, dude, chill.
Everything looks okay here. Hey there.
The code whisperer. Right? Rivet City Clinic. Okay, cool. All right, hey.
You're in the Rivet City Clinic. I'm Dr. Preston.
Yeah, hey. I need some help.
You're right. You do need a doctor. Lucky I happened along. But first, let's discuss my fee. 100 caps ought to cover it.
Yeah, what's up, man?
This won't hurt a bit.
Oh, no, I didn't want him to just heal me. I need... Once you get to four monitors, you're a member.
That wasn't so bad. Anything else I can do for you?
I love it. Yeah, hey, dude. How can I get cured of...
You can get that crap down at a quick fix. It's in the market.
Good luck, Elder.
I'm a doctor.
Can you... Like, I need someone to cure me of being an addict myself. Let's see, status... Minor red poisoning, that's okay. I don't think I'm addicted to anything anymore. Nice. See? Oh, I'm good. I'm the urban. Look at those little angel wings. Look at those. No, no. Resist. Oh, I actually have something else to show you guys. This is actually really cool. Check this out. I got this off of Etsy. It's a 3D printed.
This is a medical clinic. Please don't disturb.
I got a 3D printed stim pack. Yeah, it's legit. Like, it even has a little needle on there. It's good. It's got a little bit of heft to it. Like, I'm a big fan. Like, you can even see the little label on there and everything. Yeah. Yeah, it was sitting on my table in the whole stream next to my Pit Boy, and then I also picked up, I haven't got into a frame yet, but I saw this, and I'm just like, hey, it's Piper's, kind of looks like Mrs. Manna. So I was like, hey, I got a Mrs. Manna, it's a Piper, but, you know, Mrs. Manna. So we got ourselves a Mrs. Manna pinup that I'm gonna get hung up about. I was about to say, what up, Queen? Yeah, we can all pretend that is not Piper and that's actually Mrs.
Really
Manna.
You're not thinking of breaking into there.
Dude, chill. Yeah, no, yeah, you don't want Mrs. Manna is of the jealous flavor. Don't want her to beat me. Okay. Fallout 4 fans, you're gonna love this.
This lab is dedicated to solving real problems.
Yes. But Dr. Lee.
Dr. Lee is trying to save lives, and your constant interruptions are interfering with those efforts. Now please, stand aside.
Look at those
heels. I'm sure the good doctor's work with water purification is fascinating. But if you only knew what was at stake, the technology in that android.
What's at stake? You won't tell me what's at stake. Vagaries and secrecy. A robot's a robot, Zimmer, no matter how shiny the paint job. Now, please.
Ignorance and facetiousness. That's all you people are good for. Shiny paint job, indeed.
Uh-huh.
You can't even imagine the Commonwealth's accomplishments.
You know, if you're so smart, maybe you could help us, hmm? But no, that never even crossed your mind. Go peddle your selfishness somewhere else.
Fine, but I'm not leaving. Not until I've spoken to Dr. Lee. I'll be here when she's ready to abandon her chemistry set and talk real science.
Suit yourself.
Hey, what's up?
You there. What are you, some kind of lab assistant? No,
right?
You look a bit more weathered. Are you by any chance for hire?
That depends. What are we talking about here? It's $20 a throw.
To the point. I like that. Well, as it turns out, I've misplaced some very sensitive property.
Look at this guy. Just fucking... I love this generation of the Bethesda engine. Just because these motherfuckers in the background are just like staring at you. Missing property? What kind of property, my man?
How do I put this in a way
right?
you understand? All you know of...
And by the way, I'm a gentleman of the night.
Oaths,
so,
those
yeah.
Mr. Handshakers and whatnot. Well, that's not Dead all
ass.
A robot can be. You see, in the Commonwealth, we've made artificial persons. Synthetic humanoids. Programmed to think and feel and do whatever we need.
Fallout 4.
And occasionally, they get confused and wander off.
Like, seriously, these dudes, I think wrote... Andy's 20. So, okay. So I've been rewatching Silicon Valley because it's one of my favorite shows. Stop after season 4. Don't go on after that. But, and season 1, they're trying to figure out, like, they're like, oh man, I think I've actually told this on stream before, but they're trying to figure out, like, there's no way for them to win this competition unless, it's like, oh man, unless unless this guy goes and gives every guy a handy in the auditorium. So they started like talking with each other and like figuring out the most efficient way for this one character to give as many handies as possible inside of like 5 minutes or something like that. And it's pretty funny. Got 2 weeks of trash talk all pent up. Jeez. Okay. So and Affy, of course, Affy comes in right once I'm talking about like handies. It's like, of course, hey Affy, how's it going? That ends abruptly, and I never know what to do. Because I was having fun. Now it's over. Do I just kind of sit down now? Okay, I guess I'll just sit. Just kind of, like, hang out now. Thank you, Sora, for the party. That was fun. Well, I'll try it again. Well, yeah, I think they already had, like, Fallout 4 probably, like, the concept written. Or someone with, like, do you guys think chicken or the egg? Do you think they wrote it and kind of put this little, like, Easter egg inside of this game? Or do you think someone was going through the Fallout 3, like, storylines, and it's like, okay, we need to tie into Fallout 3 because we want all these characters from Fallout 3 to make an appearance in Fallout 4, so let's like comb through all the story and see where we can have hooks. Like, what do you guys think? Let me know in the chat. Personally, I think it was I think some fan of this decided to build on it. I think they knew what they were doing when they did this. Because this is actually a major, major quest point in the game. Sounds like slavery to me, man. You walked into a
this
sexy,
is a machine
sexy
we're
town.
Talking about. Can you enslave a generator or a water purifier?
I love
of
that.
Of course not. The same principle applies. But let's get back to your mission. You are to find this
missing android.
I've tracked him to somewhere here in the capital wasteland. He must have done something drastic, like facial surgery and a mind wipe, or else I would have found him by now. Yeah. It will be no easy task. He may not even realize he's an android. Don't upset him by talking with him. Just come get me immediately. I'll handle it. Of course. I have at my disposal advanced technology from the Commonwealth. I'd be willing to share some of it with you. Just think, you'll be the envy of all your friends. Excellent. Locate my
android. It's just
an android,
whatever.
And you won't be disappointed. Here, listen to this message he sent me. He's mocking me. I swear, I'll make him pay for that.
He just makes me so mad I could kiss him. I mean, kill him.
The Commonwealth itself is nothing but a war-ravaged quagmire of
holy shit!
Despair.
Holy shit!
Inside the sealed environment...
Goddamn Capital I Institute!
But the Institute's affairs are none of your concern. Your undeveloped mind couldn't even begin to comprehend what we've accomplished.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this... They wrote this. Yeah, they wrote this. They wrote Fallout 4. Like, yeah, this is fucking... They had a skeleton outline of Fallout 4 when they were writing Fallout 3. Like, yeah, there we go. That's it. Like, you gotta be kidding
like
me.
Like I said, I suspect you've had facial reconstruction and possibly
that's
even
really
a
cool.
mind wipe. Search the offices of doctors or techies.
So that really gives me help. Hope.
If he's come into contact with these people, there may be records. Start with Dr. Preston. He lives on this leaky boat.
Right.
See if he knows anything.
He's a
doctor, after all. Now, if you'll excuse me.
By the way, after we're done with Fallout 3, we're going straight to Fallout 4. We're going to skip over New Vegas for now. Go back to it. But anyways, this gives me hope that New Vegas 2 was written when they wrote New Vegas. And personally, I hope they go to Chicago. Because in Fallout New Vegas, you find out that the Enclave has still significant presence in Chicago. And I think New Vegas 2 is going to be real, and it's going to be set in Chicago. And I want it to be set in Chicago because, like I said, Enclave. But two, I'm a Chi-Town boy, so I really want that to be a thing. And they sprinkled that in pretty heavy. You're not going to see Manna flirt with Hancock. You're going to see Manna with Hancock. I didn't know, Hancock, you could do the deed with him. I really didn't know that. The one that I always go for, I wanted my face. My favorite, because I have a thing for damaged people, is I love myself some Kate, and I also really like the robot that becomes that gets a synth body. She's fun, mostly because she's like a sexy French lady. Okay, I'm good. I have to go now. He's gonna get all the ghoul holes.
Did you hear about the fight in the Muddy Rudder last night?
Yeah, Bill's going to have
a hello.
Tables and chairs.
Hey, get
I'm
back
sure
here, Dr. Lee.
Scrounge some from the lower deck.
Look, this is a restricted area. I'm tired of telling you people. It's you. My heavens, you look so much like him. You're James's son, aren't you?
I am.
What are you doing here?
I'm here to fuck shit up. Tell me where my fucking dad is.
Well, yes, of course I do. Don't you know who I am? I suppose James never told you. Typical. I'm Dr. Madison Lee. I worked with your father many years ago. Your mother as well, in fact. You'll have to forgive me. This has all been very stressful. With your father suddenly showing up here after being gone for so long.
That's what I think
you
about
have to
Dr.
understand
Lee.
That I... put all of that behind us. Project Purity, our work, all of it. We've moved on, even if your father hasn't.
Trying to find my father.
You mean you haven't? I assumed he sent you here. For that matter, aren't you supposed to be in a vault? James said he left you there.
Where the fuck is my dad? I have been...
Your father is no longer here, and I'd appreciate it if you didn't use that tone with me. Well, I don't know where he is. The last I knew, he was going back to the old lab. Now, will you kindly leave? I have work to do.
Yeah. How about... tell me where this lab is.
I'm going to tell you the same thing I told your father. Don't go. Whatever's left there, it isn't worth it anymore. The project was abandoned. We gave up. There's no reason to go back.
Another daddy storyline? Just keep feeding Fallout 4. Yeah, Fallout 3... Fallout 3 is, yeah, you saw the beginning of this, didn't you, Strider? Yeah. Liam Neeson is our dad, and we were a kid, and he left us in the vault. Just need to go.
Fine, suit yourself. It's in the old Jefferson Memorial Building, northwest of here.
Thank you, lady. Fuck.
Heck. Don't go too far away. I'm going to need you to move some equipment shortly. They're
fragile. Yes, Doctor.
Oh, yeah, Effie, you gotta get three in your life. Four is probably the best gameplay of any of the Fallout, the modern Fallouts, but the worst storyline. Whereas Fallout 3 has the best storyline and quests, but not the best gameplay in the world. But hey, this is what you come to Rivet City for. You come to Rivet City to see, well, there's St. Monica's Church. You can go in there. Right? They probably do have, it's probably, again, some throwaway quest line that we can't even pick up because we're slow. Capital Preservation Society. This is the reason to come to Rivet City, is the Capital Preservation Society. Look at that shit. Look at this crazy motherfucker. Oh, and bitches. Yeah, don't forget the bitches.
Impressive collection, isn't it? Well, don't be shy. Have a look around.
So he's looking up at me. I'm like a crotch level right now.
Of this little slice of American history.
There's crotch. Ruby City. Yeah, cool, man.
Ah, a fellow scholar, I see. Each of the documents in this room tells a small but important story about the history of the United States of America.
The United States of America don't exist anymore, man.
The greatest prize of all is missing from the collection.
Okay.
In 1776, the Second Judgmental Congress got together and adopted a document drafted by none other than Thomas Jefferson himself.
What are you doing this?
It was the day the United States of America earned its name.
We're gonna steal the goddamn Declaration of Independence.
Form in the Declaration of Independence.
Fuck you. Yeah. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do it.
It's Nicky Cage. And the society's collection.
Nicky Cage. Yeah, I'm in a zesty mood today.
You'll secure your place in history.
Let's go.
The man who rediscovered the Declaration of Independence. Imagine the fanfare.
Fanfare don't pay the bills. Can we stop? Yeah.
Sorry, my mind tends to wander. I will see to it that you receive a worthwhile trade. I have in my possession the only known schematic for the creation of something called the Railway Rifle. Bring me the declaration, and it's yours.
And we're cool as fucking Nicolas Cage?
Excellent.
Fuck yeah.
You won't regret it, I promise you. Imagine.
Okay, there we go. Oh, yeah, yeah. Let's do it.
In the D.C. ruins, you'll find the National Archives.
I love that twerking tiger. Makes me so happy.
The building should contain the...
Yeah, dude.
Remember?
Like, are you kidding me? Like, right there. Like, oh, it's Petrov! What? Oh! Petrov, what's up, mans? We got a celebrity in chat.
Good old Rivet City.
The man who brought us together. It's true. It's the whole father. It is the whole father. That's right. Petrov, the whole father. He doesn't know it. He's gonna be like, what is going on? He's gonna be like, oh no, what have I done? The man, the myth, the whole father.
Hey there.
Oh, what's up? Did you hear what she...
I'm on duty. Make it...
Hey, you're the one who hollered at me. Did you hear that, lady? She's like, hey there, like all sultry. And then I'm like, hey, I holler back. And she's like, We're gonna steal the goddamn Declaration of Independence. Guys, lady's flirting with me, and then she's like, oh, I'm on duty. Like, first of all, duty. It's like poop. But it's like, come on, quit being a flirt. Get out of here. Oh yeah, I got a freaking minigun? That's what I've been doing? Let's see here. I forget, like, how good everything was in condition. That's garbage. That's not doing good. Working and lurking. Baby bagel ham. Baby bagel ham. This is where we got Sydney from, so we cleared all this. Okay, let's do it. Let's steal that. Steal some of the stuff first. That Declaration of Independence. So there's some other things in these archives too. If you have high enough lockpicking and or hacking skill, you can get like the Magna Carta and the Constitution, I think, is one of the things that's available. Yeah, there's another super mutant. Let's go cap that. Nah, let's just go downstairs. Let's can I have your ammunition, lady? Please and thank you. So here we are at the National Archive building. Still history right now. And there we go. Still history right now. Right now. Oh my goodness, your cat is cute. He looks itchy though. That's all. He's a big old fluff ball. I'm very allergic to cats. I like them, but it's not a good time. Luffy, the fluffy boo. All right.
No more.
Oh really? Ah, that's my face. I hear something. Oh god, it's one of those things. Is Sydney down? Did he just fucking kill Sydney? Well, fuck, no, we're not gonna play that fucking game. No, we are reloading. We are reloading that shit.
What's up? Yeah.
Yeah, fuck this shit.
What's up?
Yeah, we are not. We are not letting Sydney die like that. Oh, fuck you! Good job, Boo. Yeah, we are not letting Sydney die like that, because she is cool as fuck. She's a tough chick. It's not how we roll.
Over here.
Oh, shit. Yeah, she is nearly dead. We need to get some stim packs. Let's get some stim packs here. And then I'll continue the tour here at the National Archives building. But we're not gonna let our boo, we're not gonna let our boo, our tough chick. The one, the only, the beautiful. Can't fast travel because there's enemies nearby. Get the fuck out of town. Where's an enemy? Get out of here. Super duper mart. Do I have any grenades? I do. That's not gonna work. Let's see here. We have to keep pizza boxes in high places. That's too funny.
Over here! We'll get him! Yeah! Yeah!
Come on! Oh, nice! Did she just take care of him? No. Come on, just step on the fragment. You know you want it. Okay, they don't want it. Try and do it the easy way. All right, let's bounce. Let's bounce to Megaton. There we go. Yeah. Gunchuck. And it's the middle of night, so we gotta wait. Yeah. So does the cat is he eating the box for like that delicious grease remains, or is he just like cardboard? time to get some stim packs for the one, the only Miss Sydney.
Hey.
I want her to get her happy ending. Eating the box. Nom nom nom.
But you came in here on your own.
Yeah.
What? Thought that hoax was long in the grave. Here, take this holotape and hear it for yourself. That was just...
Forget about it. All right.
Great. I'm afraid that goes against patient-doctor confidentiality.
Just loves to eat anything. That's awesome. Trust me, I'm a doctor.
All right. I suppose someone with medical training has to have at least a bit of compassion.
Just eat everything.
And maybe you can talk some sense into the boy. Leo Stahl. That boy got himself a problem with Jet. I've caught him in here 2 to 3 times trying to steal what I keep around for anesthetic. Yeah. Not even his own family knows it. He goes up to the water treatment plant at night to get high. I don't know.
Do you guys like to get high?
Maybe you can.
Yeah, sure, man. Whatever. But I need to buy some medical supplies. Yeah. Give me as... Oh, shoot. I don't have that much money. I only have 336 caps. Okay. Let's sell some 5 mil. Some Brotherhood of Steel stuff. Like... It's not gonna go very far. Let's sell some energy sales. Environmental suit. Flamer fuel. These frags. Hat jet. Okay. Laser rifle, laser pistol, minigun, missiles. Power fist? I want to keep those. Never know when you need a power fist. Ladies, gentlemen. Let's see. Now I will take as many stim packs as I can get. Awesome. Peace.
You done?
I'm good to go now.
Yeah. Bye.
Greasy. Yeah, I have been known to eat some greasy cardboard myself.
Yeah. Thanks.
Things happen.
What's
you
up?
Know what I mean? You hurt?
It's. What's up? It's. What's up?
What is up, Boo?
It.
Alright, is she hurt anymore?
What's up?
Are you hurt? Alright, cool. Alright, let's go back on our tour of the National Archives. Absolute unit. So when you say like unit of cat, like how heavy is Kevin? And was he named after Kevin from The Office? A unit of cat. Now, how much does a unit of cat really weigh? Let's go steal the goddamn Declaration of Independence. A whole unit. Whole unit of cat. Oh, geez. Going on a bear hunt. Going on a bear hunt. Hope catch a big one. I've been listening to too many kids' songs.
Hey! Let's go.
Ah, it's a centaur! Uh-huh. Those things are gross.
Can't stand the sight of your own blood.
So a centaur. Oh God! Oh, my flesh is burning. My flesh, that was not ideal. My flesh was burning. Is everyone okay? Is everyone on the tour okay? That was not ideal. So this right here is a centaur. So centaurs are, so super mutants are people that are exposed to the forced evolutionary virus. And sometimes it doesn't go exactly right, and that's how a centaur is created, is when the forced evolutionary virus doesn't work right, and that's what you get is a centaur. It's pretty gross. It's, ooh, a laser rifle. I'll take that.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, that. Yeah, that's 5.56. It's just too small of a caliber to do any damage against these guys. Ah, my face. Where? He's shooting you in the face. What do you mean, where? Did he just kill Sydney? Sydney down. Sydney just got her shit rocked. And, you know, fuck it. Let's just pour one out for Sydney. You don't get your happy ending. I'm gonna take your SMG though. I'm sorry, lady. But you did. You dead as shit. RIP Sydney. That is not the best button. Rest in peace. Red Horn, rest in peace. That's awesome. Anyways, so we got Sydney's ultimate SMG. It's pretty BA. We can stop wearing this freaking Talon combat armor, because fuck those guys. There we go. There we go. There we go. Oh no. Okay. Sorry. My mouse got to the other monitor. Okay. Scroll. I forgot to give a huge shout out. We actually got ourselves a couple new followers since like two streams ago. We got Diva followed us. She's a super cool. Oh no, hold on, I gotta fix my chat. My chat got scrolled as well. There we go. Diva, super cool streamer. She followed us. Also did. What's that? Drago Cataphract. Halen 17. And then yesterday was Iron Man Duck. Huge thanks to everyone for the follows. Love it. Appreciate it. Sydney died. RIP Sid. Guess he just couldn't cut the business. You know what I mean? Not everyone's made to be a relic hunter. Oh no! I tried to force it, and it didn't work. I should have known better. Don't ever just try to force things in a hole. It never works. I don't think this is the right place. Need to be in the basement. Right, we need to be down here. Oh, that sucks so bad that Sydney died. She actually has a really nice story that you can end it or come to a nice conclusion for her and all this stuff. But very hard. Oh. I'm very hard, but I can't. I think I might actually have to.
Ben, today I address you with a message of utmost urgency. Our defenses have been breached, and soon we'll engage the enemy. Remember, The will of the people is the only legitimate foundation of any government, and to protect its free expression should be our first objective. As your leader, Button Gwinnett, distinguished representative of Georgia, I promise you I have not yet begun to fight.
Okay, so we got some dude who's gonna be a...
Men, we can't let the enemy's progress dissuade us from our task. We must defend our freedom and our right to be independent. Strike now and strike hard. You may defend.
Strike now and strike hard. Ooh. Ooh. Pulse mine. Pulse mines are good against robots. Oh, God, he's still alive. My face.
Oh shit.
Maybe I'm too low level to be able to handle this.
Bastard.
Maybe I should not be doing this one yet. So I'm getting my shit rocked. You know what? We were gonna steal the Declaration of Independence later. We are not doing so hot. We're gonna skadoosh. I am gonna skadoosh. We are only level 9. We are not doing so hot. We lost Sydney. We're fucking disasters. We're gonna get out. I don't know. What other quest do we got going? Wasteland Survival Guide. Power of the Atom. I haven't disarmed that. Shit. Oh, let's go off. Let's go off reservation a little bit. Let's go see Tenpenny Tower. We haven't seen that yet. Let's go to Tenpenny Tower. Let's take a step back. Take some deep breaths. You know, just kind of calm down, relax a little bit.
It'll be restored soon. Please stand by.
Nice. I will take that. Show us the world. I wanna show you the world.
Good to see you.
Something. I don't know the words. Alright, we're gonna go to Tenpenny Tower. Tenpenny Tower. We're finally gonna get there. Guys are gonna meet Alistair Tenpenny, the guy who wanted us to blow up Megaton. And, spoiler alert, I'm gonna shoot him in the fucking face. Holy shit, that is a fucking Yagwai! Fuck this! Book this! Where's the button? Where's this button?
Fuck this shit, I'm out!
What the fuck? What the fuck? No! 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 No!
Excuse me, please! Fuck this shit, I'm out!
Nope!
Fuck this shit, I'm out! Alright then! I don't know what the fuck just happened, Jesus. But I don't really care. I'ma get the fuck out of here. This shit, I'm
fuck this. try this again.
Welcome to Megan.
These are not going well. We can do this. Right? Rip. I'm getting my ass pounded in not a very good way. The opposite of a good time. Not a good time. At all. Jesus.
Full of the capital wasteland, it is I, $3.
$3, shut the fuck up. There's a fucking Yagwe. There's the fucking Yagwe again. Fuck that shit. Fucking Yagwe. Fuck that. Fuck. Fuck. My ass. That is my booty hole. He's just like chewing on my butthole. Like you hear that grunting behind me, just like, I'm gonna fuck me. There we go. Look at that thing. Look at that fucking monster. So Yagwe is the radiated version of a black bear that's native to Virginia and Maryland. And Yagwe is, I think it's a mythical Chinese beast, is a Yagwe. There we go. Look at that. You fucking... Yeah, fucking... Yeah, that's what you get. I'm gonna eat that Yagwe meat. Whew! Right? Redemption. Seriously, what's a Yagwe doing? Like, this is like the beginning area. Like, yo, is it gonna be like another Yagwe? Just kind of like, the fuck is that? This is like the worst tour. It's another goddamn Yagwe. Wow. Yeah, you said it, Owen. Let's see. Where's that fucker? Oh, it's a mole rat. Okay. Cool. We got that. I can deal with the mole rat. God damn it. Shit, this place is dangerous. Did everyone remember their towel? Like, I should have made sure to check with that before we started our tour, that everyone had their towel with them. We're gonna go to 10 Penny Tower, which is a nice, safe place here in the Capital Wasteland. It's a nice, ritzy place. Holy crap! I'm a bear! Who wakes my pants up? What? That's weird. Yeah, what's up, I Heart Bears? How's your day? How's the life? Sora, I guess, maybe you can confirm this for us, but I heard a rumor. What's up, Boo?
Hey there.
I need some medical supplies. I heard that Sora is a booty connoisseur. Comment? Can you confirm? Deny? How's your booty? Etc. 236 caps I need. You rang. Yeah, we just asking for some clarification. Need to sell some more stuff. Yeah, let's... 33 mag. Throw that. Okay, I'm broke.
A pleasure.
Is it me or is he frozen? Oh, no, am I frozen? I think it's you.
Later.
Yeah, it's you. My preview window says I'm good. It might be you. I hope it's you. Well, I don't hope it's you. I hope it stops freezing. Because I want you to hang out, Affy. Affy was playing that freaking Under the Ocean game again today. I was able to peek in every once in a while I was working. That game is beautifully terrifying. If you haven't checked out Affy playing that, definitely do it. Subnautica, yes, that's the one. Subnautica, it is beautifully terrifying. And look how. Oh, Enclave bot, don't wanna fuck with that thing. It's so beautiful. I can't hear him. He is frozen. Oh no. Let's try. Could someone type in the chat for Affy to try refreshing her browser? I don't want to exit this. What the fuck's that up there? Is that not? Goddamn Yagua. Look at that thing. Look at that thing. All right, we're going to take a quick detour because I don't want to fuck with the Yagua. I don't get down with that. So we're going to take a brief. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. We're going to take a brief detour from our... Oh, guys! Awesome! Awesome! Awesome. Okay, we bumped in. Oh. Okay, it's better now. Okay, awesome. We bumped into one of my favorite factions in this game. It's the Brotherhood Outcast. These guys... After they give me the intro, I'll.
You're not involved in this. You want to
keep your head down, idiot. Raider incoming.
I keep it that way.
Hey. Trying to help you guys out. What's up? Please don't kill me. Where's this one running to? Well, I'm following. Because this seems like an awesome glitch. This is hilarious. We got a really good glitch here. They're not supposed to run like that. They're supposed to keep guarding Fort Independence. So we might have had a... Oh shit! Oh shit! They're about to... That one's gonna pick up the minigun. Oh shit! Defender Rockfall! Oh my god, that's hilarious! Oh my god, this is so awesome! No way! That was a great glitch! That is a great glitch! This makes me so happy. Right? Upgrades. So in Fallout 3, Fallout 4 kind of bummed me out, because in Fallout 4 you could wear power armor, like, right away. In Fallout 3, you actually have to get pretty far in the main questline before you can wear power armor. So... I can't really use that yet. But what I can use... I can't really use that either. I sold like all my five mil. So... Oh, fudge. Hold on. I need to like... There we go. Do like a scroll lock or something. Oh, and there we go. Fuck me. God damn it. Fucking... God, control alt. Where's the delete button when you need it? Fucking crashed. Fucking crashed after that glitch. Oh, this game is so frustratingly awesome. Okay, let's reload. So, brief history lesson. And why those guys were important. Those guys were Brotherhood outcasts. So when the Brotherhood of Steel originated... It's too soon. I did tip the scales. Actually, before we do this, I'm actually going to... unload some of the DLCs. Because I want to be able to listen to the radio without so many spoilers. So let's play. Let's just deselect Broken Steel, that DLC. So we should be good to go. Okay. So when the Brotherhood sent Elder Alliance, who we'll meet later, out east to Washington, D.C. from California, he was sent to gather technology, secure government installations, and do what the Brotherhood of Steel always does, which is collect tech, hoard it for themselves, and really not necessarily help the people in the wasteland. That's not what they do. They're not about that. They're just... it's us and ours, you know. We don't recruit from the locals. You're born into the Brotherhood of Steel. You can't be recruited, and all that good stuff. So when he gets out to the east, Elder Alliance, who's the chief, is just like, man, okay, I see this plight of the people in the wasteland. I'm gonna help them. So many of us have died coming out east. We're going to start recruiting from the locals, etc., etc. Eventually, there's just a breaking point, and a bunch of their paladins and knights just say, you know what, dude, fuck off. This is not what the Brotherhood of Steel does, and they actually break off, and they form the Brotherhood of Steel Outcasts. Fun story, Affy, is that I majored in history in my undergrad, so I kind of have a brain for this sort of stuff. I know a lot of the history of Fallout, just... Yes, that's okay. That should be good. Yeah, for some reason, just really sticks in the whole brain spice very well. Well, that's disappointing, but that is... Fallout experience in a nutshell. I should be saving more often. Including death, if you remain here. But so what's cool in Fallout 4 is the little bit of a spoiler, but the Brotherhood of Steel show up in an airship, right? That's not really by accident. Ugh, there's a fucking Jaguar. I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna cheat a little bit. Let's just wait for this guy. Is that they show up in the Commonwealth in that airship, right? How do they know how to build an airship like that, you ask? They already done it. When they went from California to DC, they didn't walk that entire way. They went in airships. And I think they're in Fallout Brother... There's a Fallout Tactics Brotherhood of Steel game that I think kind of covers that, but their aircraft get, like, downed or something. I'm not very familiar with that game, so you might have to Google that. Fuck you. Here he comes. Here he comes. Here he comes. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit, guys. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. You guys are running away. Bug this. Oh, what's up, Stockholm? I do not want to shoot you. I don't want to shoot you, Crow. I really, really would like to shoot that. He's dead. Stockholm, the sniper up there. fucking badass. Thank you. That was terrifying. So anyways, so when I saw in Fallout 4 the airship, I was like, oh shit. Like, maybe they already have had, they probably had the dismantled airship still hanging around. Because in this game, they detail that they went up to New York, and they also went to Pittsburgh, where there's a DLC for the pit, which is pretty fucking badass, and I have it. We disabled the, oh, fuck it. What's up, guys? See? Look at them. I'm fucking patrolling shit, see?
Great. Here's some of the local wildlife.
Like, listen to that racist shit. That's awesome. Call me wildlife. But yeah, they painted themselves red, and I'm gonna follow them. That what they did is not cool. You can't just over mutiny. They mutinied. That's what they did. Is that the Brotherhood of Steel is actually is funny that I'm like, oh, they mutinied, so that's bad. The Brotherhood of Steel was founded by mutinous American military at Malparaiso, I think is the fort. Fort Malparaiso. They discovered the forced evolutionary virus and that kind of just really bad stuff that was going on, and they mutinied against the government right before the bombs fell. I want to say like 2 days before the bombs fell, like 2 or 3 days. And they formed the Brotherhood of Steel then. Then the bombs fell, and they, since then, generation after generation, they formed this cult-like organization and like technocratic, well, not tech, like a tech worshipping cult, like a tech worshipping military cult. Like, so when people are like, oh, that, you know, they're fascists and stuff, it's like, well, yeah, I mean, these guys are ex-military. Like, they formed their entire society around military doctrine. And yeah, so yeah, they are definitely fascist leaning, but you know, it makes sense given that history. Not the only thing I'm deep thing I'm here for. I'm just staring at this one's booty. I mean, I am mesmerized. Like, that is a solid booty. Look at that thing. So these guys mutinied, so they know that, like, they are not. Like, when the brother, like, it's one of those things, like, solid, especially on this engine. Yeah. It's like, when the rest of the Brotherhood shows up, because they, I forget when they started to go out east. But when the rest of the Brotherhood shows up, they're like, oh, we're the cool ones. They'll totally like agree with us that Elder Lions is a piece of shit, and we'll be cool, man. Like, everyone's gonna be like, yeah, those guys are, yeah, leave it. Like, Elder Lions, that guy's a punk ass bitch, and we'll be allowed back in. And what's going on here? Oh, fucking rumble. Oh shit, they just took a bat to that guy's back. He's just taking it like a bitch. Oh shit, Gatling laser. Gatling laser's going off. What are they doing? Oh my god, they're gonna clear some shit for me. Should I follow these guys and just wait for them to... Yes, here we go. Let's just listen to them.
Fortified bunker in the middle of a DC hellhole.
Thanks, guys.
Ain't life grand? Seems we've got a bit of news. Just listen to this. Okay, It seems the settlement of Grey Ditch is.
Does that split continue beyond Fallout 3?
Residents have a contract with the caravaners.
Did one of those motherfuckers die from that? What?
So if
yes.
By Grey Ditch, you may want to pop in.
Thank
and see
you.
What's what.
Snap.
Thanks for listening.
This is that deep lore that you've come here for. It does not. If you read, I thought they were shooting me. Oh shit! I thought that they were getting mad that I looted their dead comrade. They're like,
great. Here's some of the local wildlife.
On the Prydwen in Fallout 4. If you break into, I think, I forget, what's his name in Fallout 4? Malcolm? I forget his name. But if you break into his room, you actually get, Maxon, yeah. You actually get to meet him in this game as a little boy. Which is why, like, I lost my mind when I saw him, because it's actually really cute. Like, you get some more background on them. Should I follow those guys? No, I'm not going to follow those guys. What was I saying? If you break into his room and read his terminals, you find out that after the events of the... Fuck, shit. Not again. Hold on. Contact. Help me, outcast boys! Help me! Okay, so I'm gonna try to get this Yagwai to the outcast, guys. There we go. Thank you. Maybe I should hang out with these bitches. Oh shit, it's still coming. Not a good time. Run in a circle.
Did you see that shit?
Fuck this shit, I'm out. Fuck this shit, I'm out.
No thanks.
Don't mind me. I'ma just grab my
stuff
and leave. Excuse me, please. Fuck this shit, I'm out.
Nope.
Fuck this shit, I'm out.
Alright then.
I don't know what the fuck just happened, but I don't really care.
I'm gonna get the fuck up out of here.
This shit, I'm out.
His jacket is pretty fucking slick. Alright. So, after the events of this game, Sarah Lyons, Elder Lyons' daughter, appears to have taken over as So this is all on the top of the dome. Just getting all the random NPCs dead to save you, yeah. Let's hope we don't fucking bump into many more Yagwai. God damn. I'm gonna tell the story. So it seems like after the events of this game, things are going kind of smoothly for everyone. And that Sarah Lyons either becomes elder or there's a scuffle. It seems like Maxon had Sarah Lyons killed. Like, it's pretty, like, I'm convinced he had Sarah Lyons killed. And he took over the Brotherhood, the DC Brotherhood, and obviously has a much more hardline, more traditional approach as a Brotherhood member. So he was able to reconcile with the Brotherhood, the outcasts, reconcile, get them together with the DC Brotherhood, and that's when they went on their conquest to the Commonwealth that has the Institute, which is like the epitome of the Brotherhood's bad guy, like, image in their head. Okay. There's some bad guys around here somewhere. We're just gonna just gonna try to skadoosh right on through. God damn fucking Yagwai. You see that shit? I'm going this way. Fuck. I don't remember it being this fucking hard just to get to the freaking Tenpenny Tower. There's like Yagwais everywhere. God damn. And remember, don't feed the Yagwai. This is Three Dog. Reminding you, don't feed the Yagwai. How was that impersonation? Was it okay? I'm not going that way. We're gonna get. See, oh! There we go.
Stupid sexy Flander.
That's not the right button, but that's okay. Fucking Tenpenny Tower standing tall and erect in the capital wasteland. See that shit? Goddamn Yagwai's everywhere, man. Rad Scorpion. Motherfucker running away from something. There's a Yagwai over there. Skadoosh. Skadoosh time. What the fuck? That guy is straight up just beating up a... I don't got that. What's that shit? Shit is not going good for Mr. Man. I should have done a sneak build for, giving you guys a tour of the wasteland. Good old Tenpenny Tower. And look at that fucking man. Can't see him from here. I don't think I even have enough caps to get in right now. Adding vehicles? They don't need the pores hanging around, that's for sure. I think how they did in Fallout 4 was very good.
We've got plenty of bottle caps. Let me in, goddammit.
How many times do we have to go through this? You're not getting in.
I can stand here all day yelling at you through this damn speaker.
That's where I was gonna go to.
I've already told you Tenpenny won't allow zombies to live here.
Who the hell are you calling a zombie?
You're definitely not human, that's for damn sure. For the last time, no zombies allowed.
That's racist.
Can't you tell the difference between me and a feral? Fine, I'll show you the goddamn difference. Just you wait. You'll get yours, all of you. I'm really not in the mood, so leave me alone.
All right, dude.
I thought I told you to get the hell out of here. For the...
Is that how you treat all of us?
No, just those damn ghouls. Sorry, thought you were one of them. Ghoul or not, I must inform you that... This ain't a theme park, kid. Perhaps you'll fit in around here better than I thought. Don't bother Tenpenny or the other residents. Welcome to Tenpenny Tower. Don't do anything stupid.
So, I was about to say, vehicles are already in the Fallout lore. Fallout 1 and 2, you can get a car that will enable you to do fast traveling. Look how fancy this place is. And then in Fallout 4, they brought back, or they did that really cool vertibird option where you can, like, hitch a ride on there. But you gotta be careful with it because, like, gasoline engines don't, like, gas is super, like, that was one of the, like, the fossil fuels going away was one of the motivations for the great, like, the wars that led up to the Great War, the resource wars and all that. So if they were going, if they were going to do a vehicle, it has to be nuclear powered. I don't know. If done well.
Welcome to Tenpenny Tower. We are safe from the wasteland in here.
Ooh.
Welcome to Tenpenny Tower.
Yeah. I agree. I don't have any money. So this is Tenpenny Tower. This is where all the rich people in the Capital Wasteland hang out. We're gonna go kill Tenpenny, though. Because that guy wanted to nuke an entire town, and we want to talk about him.
And how are you then?
Hello?
Hey there.
Let's see, how do I go up the stairs? Yes, yeah. I kind of like that, because...
Yes.
How do we get upstairs to see Tenpenny? How do we get there again? I say as I also... Fuck that time. Let's see. How much do you want... Do you guys want to see the mushroom cloud? Do we want to go evil? Do we want to restart and go evil? Is that what you want? Is that really what you want? Because I have the save right here, buddy. We can go evil if you want. We can restart this thing and go evil. We can do it.
I'm quite well, thank you.
Ooh.
Charm, I'm sure.
I don't know.
Hello.
Pretty nice place to live, if you ask me. Oh, does 76 have some new updates coming in? Nice.
I'm not here for your entertainment.
You can stay the goody-goody route. Things are not going well, though. This... Alright, let's get up to Tenpenny.
Evil.
Penthouse suites. Yeah, we can go.
Mr. Tenpenny isn't.
He isn't taking a call. Oh, yeah.
Hold on there a minute.
Charm.
Oh, alright, I'll let you in. But if Tenpenny hollers because he isn't expecting you, you're dead.
Oh. Yeah, cool, man. Just, let's close this door.
Nice to see you. Carry on. Fancy that. A visitor. I seldom get visitors, which is a
tiresome shame. Oh, that's pretty cool.
Old
shame, yeah.
Because I'm usually relentlessly bored out of my right mind. all of these confounded people fluster about like I'm made of eggshells and about to fall to pieces in any moment. I'm surprised they even let you in. So, what do you think of my fine tower here? It's quite the jewel of the wasteland, isn't it? I dare say I'm quite proud of it myself. I say, must you be
big
so caustic?
Fucking deal, you just moved
come
in.
Now, a lot of work went into turning this husk. I've had help, of course. Especially in Mr. Burke, an absolute gem of a man. He certainly has a way of getting done what needs to get done. Then it was a matter of getting the right type of tenants with the right type of assets, and the rest is, as they say, history.
Why blow up Megaton, dude?
I complained offhand one day about how I thought that heap of metal on the horizon was a bit of an eyesore. Mr. Burke offered to take care of it. Burke is such an agreeable man, isn't he?
Guy,
I don't know how I got along without him. I practically don't have to think about things anymore.
He takes
care of everything. I seldom even have to ask. He's a real go-getter, that one. We need more men like him if we're going to rebuild the world.
Expeditions the pit. He was going to kill an entire town because he didn't like... He could have moved rooms. But he's like, no, I'm just going to kill everyone. You don't have a problem killing all those people?
Oh, no. I'm certainly rather sore about all of that. But certain sacrifices must be made. Besides, Burke assured me that bomb was quite unstable. I asked Burke to suggest they vacate. It was all a matter of time. Think of it as helping speed along the process of natural selection. Don't lose any sleep over it.
What are you shooting out there, man?
Why, anything I want, dear boy. Anything I want. Wasteland safari. Very relaxing.
So he's straight up shooting people. Time to kill this motherfucker. Right? Gained karma. The game wanted us to do it. Fuck that guy. And you know what? I'm gonna wear his fucking suit out here. Right out the front door. I look fucking good in it, too. Look at this. Look at this fine ass motherfucker. There we go. Let's see if we can just walk right out the front door. I don't think anyone even notices we did it. They don't. How would they know?
Can I help you?
How would they know? Yeah, it's not a unique sniper rifle. It's just a basic AF sniper rifle. Tic-tac. How would they know? Okay, yeah, I might have to do that. I'm just wearing their boss's outfit right out the front.
I'm not here for your entertainment.
So cool. So that's Tenpenny Tower. We just killed that motherfucker. Got his sniper rifle. Let's see what. You know what? I'm gonna continue west because I think that's how. There's like a raider hideout that has a unique shotgun in it that I really like getting. This is also where all the ghouls are hanging out. Is right over here. We want to go over here. So, the wasteland is riddled with many, many remnants of the old world. And here is a shopping center right by Tenpenny Tower that, if memory serves, this one over...
Voice of America.
This one has a mannequin in it with Lucky sunglasses. I think it's right in here. Yep, Lucky sunglasses. Fuck. What the fuck is that? Who the fuck are you?
Watch it, will you?
Holy shit. A scavenger. You know, just casually just hanging out with a goddamn missile launcher on her back. You know, bless it. My scroll just freaked out on me again. Let's see. We'll probably crash the game again. Sweet. It worked. Yeah. That's...
Hey there.
You know, we've been really good this entire time.
Fire.
Yeah. Yeah. But Lucky Shades, baby, gives you one luck. Just strapped. But I'm not going to wear those because I'm afraid they're going to break. But yeah, it gives you plus one luck. And Nuka-Cola Quantum. I'm a bad person, dude. It's just a baller move. Exactly. I mean, you're walking around the wasteland with a freaking, Pugilism Illustrated. Nice. You're just walking around with a freaking missile launcher on your back. No one's gonna... People are gonna be like, that guy's fucking crazy. Companions. Disturbing. Probably recreating that, right? Okay, nice. Nice. Let's open this safe then. Three bottle caps. Really? Are you fucking with me? Three bottle caps? And we don't need any junk. But yeah.
Over here!
Fuck you guys. Fuck. I hate these guys so much. Weapons. Let's see here. Missile launcher. Here we go, guys. Ah. Oh yeah, that was pretty awesome. That was even worth getting. I totally messed on that. Ooh, they are tearing my butt. There we go, there's one. There's another one, okay. Quit zooming over there. No, we're gonna die. There we go. And sunglasses. You always need the sunglasses. Okay, let's try that again. Let's go combat shotgun. This guy. is. He must be, like, their new guy on the team, because they just gave him a knife and said, go get him, Tiger. And then throw a frag right, or frag mine right there. Oh, invisible fence. Okay, great. So we're just gonna hang out. I just shot that guy in the face with a rocket, and he's just like, yeah, I'm good. Fuck, man. And sunglasses. The sunglasses are always killed, man. Yeah. Jeez. You guys. Stop. Just, like, come on. Guys. Stop. Yeah, you guys have small peepees. Come on. Quit it. Goddamn. Don't even announce it. That was really fun. Yeah. We are not doing so good. We are burning through caps like nobody's business. There comes a turning point where you can just like print caps. We are not there yet though. Hey, Sora. Welcome back. We're gonna kill some Zed heads. With the missile launcher. Hopefully these are all ferals. If not, people are not gonna be happy with me. Look, those were all friends. Lurking and eating my... Ooh, what's for dinner? What did I have for dinner? Shit, I completely forgot. Oh yeah, I had chili. Mrs. Manna made chili. It was delightful. Dinner I barely know. Get the fuck out of here. Too much. You're too much. Alfredo. Ooh. The chunkiest of the pasta sauces. It's my fave. It's like... Out of ammo. That's awkward. Look at those. The Moist Hole Brigade! Oh. you guys just stop.
Stop.
The whole patrol runs deep. So deep!
How deep do they run, Daddy?
Deeper than you could ever imagine.
Shit. You guys suck. A lot.
Just a lunchbox.
So deep. Put her ass to sleep.
That's not a way we can go. Go this way. Ooh, Stimpak. Not the only thing that's blue. I missed both of those. That's human flesh. You can just straight up eat human flesh. That's awesome.
Douchebags.
Alright, let's see here.
In the face! He's out!
Solution, the revolution. Whew, whew. I thought it was the solution, like, you know, like the solution. No, it's
you
just
there.
A revolution.
Put your weapons away. Come over here. No funny business unless you want to get shot.
I'm good, man. I was just slaying some ghouls, yo. Some ferals.
What are you doing here? It's not safe for your kind around.
What do you
here?
Mean, your kind?
Oh, yeah? Is he expecting you? Well, then, run along. It's not wise to keep Roy waiting. Has a bit of a temper, that one. You watch yourself.
Yeah, sure thing. Does he have anything I can steal? He sure does. I'm hidden. I'm just gonna steal some shit. Stealing some shit. Stealing some shit. So if you keep neutral, what's nice is if you keep your karma neutral, is that the Talent Company and the regulators don't come like hunting you down. Like no one gives a shit about you. So if you nuke Megaton, the regulators, like, come and just start hunting your ass, like, right away. I think it's level 8. Once you get to level 8, regulators or talent companies start hunting you. But if you nuke Megaton, you've got a ways to go for positive karma. You gotta, like, suck everyone off in the wasteland to get that much
yes.
karma.
Hello. What is it?
I have to go now. Scene. Regulators, mount up! Can I steal some of your guys' shit? You guys got some good shit to steal? I will steal anything not nailed down. Where's Roy? He's taking a little nappy poo. I am hidden. 3-0-8. Nice. That sniper rifle ammunition in this game is 3-0-8. You can't just be any geek, right? You gotta be able to handle an iron, if you know what I mean. Let's see if there's any other good stuff. 3-0-8 is expansive. Oh, I think I got their, yeah. Now we can see energy cell. Gimme. What else is in here? Shotgun shell, darts. That's such a good song. Let's keep going. So you can either choose to work for the Tenpenny Tower security and kill all these peeps. Cause hey, that's the way to Tenpenny Tower right there. So you could kill all the ghouls. Oh nice, big book of science too. Nice. Big book of science, I think, moves your science up by one, but I think my science is already maxed out, so I'm just gonna sell that. Or you can work for Roy Phillips, and you can have all the feral. I think he ends up getting a bunch of the feral ghouls to run into Tenpenny Tower and kill everyone, but he gives you a ghoul mask that you can wear. And when you have the ghoul mask on, ghouls, like feral ghouls, will not attack you. They'll think you're a ghoul, which is baller AF. So I always recommend going that route. Yeah, that's the better way. Because then you can just run through all these sewers without the metro tunnels without having to worry about anything.
So you killed a bunch of feral ghouls. Is that supposed to sound impressive?
I
got no compassion left for those mindless freaks. But they were a nice deterrent keeping out smooth-skinned bastards like yourself. Biding our time, making plans, getting ready. Tenpenny and his pack of elitist wannabes. We've
cool,
got
man.
Rights, and we'll take them if they aren't given to us. I already got a plan. They think I'm a monster? I'll show them the real monsters. We'll unleash our feral brethren on them. All those bigoted sons of bitches will get torn apart. Trouble is getting past the damn subway access door. You see, there's some kind of escape door that leads from...
He is so pretty. Oh, I shouldn't have killed Tenpenny. Because there's a way that you can... Oh, the diplomatic way. You can convince everyone... You can convince crucial people with a high enough speech score, which I have. You can convince all the people in the tower to be like, cool.
Ah, but by all means, try you get that escape door in the... What? You think so, do you?
Oh, We already killed him, though. He is so pretty. He's a ghoul. Oh, he's a rod. And...
pay more attention to what you're doing.
Oh, nice. Let's just steal that. But I already killed Tenpenny, so I can't do that option anymore, I don't think. Help the ghouls get into Tenpenny Tower. And there's no way I'm going to be able to open that door anytime soon because it's 100 lockpick, which I don't have. Or I have to get the key, which... I'm tired of you guys. I'm tired of you. God damn. There's a fragment. Yeah, that's what I was about to say. It's getting a France clock, isn't it?
In my head.
There's another one. In the face. Oh, there's all the radioactive barrels that they were hanging around. Because ghouls get healed via radiation. And it rots their brains, hence how they become feral. Right, yeah. The door is activated elsewhere. Oh, all right, I'm just gonna go into the basement and open it. Tenpennies. Fudge out of here first, though. Sorry, everyone, we couldn't do it the super peaceful way. I'll just achieve the revolution's goals the evil way. But yeah, there's a way that you can convince everyone. Key people in the community, a Tenpenny Tower to be cool, with the ghouls showing up, and that is the best way, you know, a bunch of people don't end up dying that way. I think if I go this way. I think there was some stairs up. No, that goes further down. I might just walk around in circles. I might just be walking around in circles. I am. Because that's the radiation barrels. Do-do-do. Do-do-do. Guy who just abandoned his guard post after I showed up. He's like, oh, okay, that guy's obviously the only guy who's going to be coming through, so we can just stop guarding the entrance now. Fucking Talon Company's right up here. I bet you $10. I just lost $10. Okay, there's Tenpenny Tower. Let's go over there and open that fucking door for him. And then we can loot all the dead bodies. Give me the loot, give me the loot.
Give me a second. Keep your panties on.
What do you know? Going commando, boo. Oh, it's not here. It's down this way. Hey, how's it going, guys? Don't mind me. Do 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 do. Don't mind me. Don't mind me. Just kinda going around. to your access area. Don't mind me. Requires a key. Interesting. Requires a key.
Edgar, dear, I think Mr. Ling is asking for trouble by teasing all the male guards the way he does. What he needs to do is find a nice woman and settle down.
Oh, I don't know about all that.
You're just humoring me, aren't you? You haven't heard a word I've said, have you?
Yes, dear.
Sometimes I get the feeling I'm talking to myself.
Sounds familiar. So, it's probably in his pocket. Do I have any stealth bullets? Probably not. Unarmed increase by one. Don't think I have any stealth bullets. Oh, it says the chat's pause for scroll. There we go.
What do you think you're doing?
Yeah, he's got the key to the room. But he's always got this honky, like right there. So I'm very much detected. Let's wait 19 hours, middle of the night. Let's see. Let's see if there's a guy looking right at his back.
I think I'll turn you into the
Okay, he's just, he went to sleep somewhere. Interesting.
Yes.
Dr. Banfield.
Hello?
Hello. Other dude. How am I gonna get that key? Need to find out where the chief goes. What up, Susan Lancaster? Just eat.
Yes?
Find out where Chief Gustavo sleeps and just kill him in his sleep. Oh, you're drunk. You're sleeping with empty bottles. It's kind of sad. Edgar Wellington II.
Cut the ghoulies a break. If they've got the caps and you've got the space, it's a win-win, right? What do you say?
Speed tour, yeah.
Until next time.
Herbert Darling Dashwood.
When you're listening to Galaxy News,
Bad
it hurts. And now a super important public service announcement.
I do like Dashwood too. Sorry, darling. You are pretty. He is actually a pretty cool dude, but things have to happen.
But for God's sake, don't go waving the white flag. They'll just strangle you.
This tour took a dark turn. Oh, really? Oh, yeah. Ooh, a stealth boy, too. Hey, you know, it's... You guys said that... Oh, God, that is his jawbone. You guys were saying that I was a goody two-shoes. I just... But didn't want to blow the nuke. Yeah, things have taken a dark turn in this game. We're just gonna... Yeah. How did one blow to the head not kill the... The guy is a freaking seasoned adventurer. He's badass. The Wasteland... I used to be a good person. The Wasteland does change people. I can't kill this town. But just straight up murder a guy in his sleep, yeah. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Oh shit. Hunting. Nope. We gotta walk away from that for a second. I clicked one of the wrong things. So now we're gonna kill this entire tower full of people. So I am still killing a town. Routing. Nope. Locking. I'm still killing an entire town full of people. Balance has been restored, right?
Great job, kid. Meet me around front. I have something for you to keep the ferals from gnawing on your ass.
How bad is my karma now? Neutral! We're neutral! We're neutral! We are balanced, baby! We are balanced! I do have an ultra wide as my main monitor. And the resolution's set at 2K. Is everything like super stretched and weird looking? Doesn't look too bad on the preview. But yeah, I just killed that entire like tower full of people. So yeah, balance has been restored. Game looks great. Good.
Great job, kid. Here, take this mask. It'll keep you safe from the ferals. Just don't get too close to them, or they'll sniff you out. Don't forget.
So we got the ghoul mask, baby. Level up. We're sort of evil. Alright, now we're at speech 100. Let's move our freaking... Yeah, let's... Nah. Let's start beefing up our repair skill. So then... That's where we want to be. Put it on me. Oh yeah, it's on me, baby. Impartial meditate... Nah, mediation. Impartial mediation. Here and now, immediately grants an additional experience level. Ooh. Size matters. Nice. You know it. Give it to me. Give it to me, baby. Give it to me, baby. Let's just bump up repair again. 69. Nice. Oh, animal friend. Yes. Yagwais will not attack anymore. Yes. They're gonna love me. The second level actually really works awesome. If you can get like a pack of Yagwais hanging out with you. And there is an area where there is a Yagwai den that inside of it has one of the bobbleheads or something rare in it. But now that I have Animal Friend, I don't have to worry about Yagwais anymore.
I'm gonna get the shit out of you.
Should I feel bad? Huh. I can't activate the terminal. I'm just getting... like, I'm just getting straight up negative karma from that. Where's this dead body? I'm just getting negative karma for that. I swear, if we got some regulators, we're gonna be rolling up on our ass. Okay.
Move along, please.
Well, this is awkward, man. Everyone's dead, and there's like guts and shit.
Hi.
Whoa, like, do you have any idea what's going on, bro? That guy's just like chilling. Sorry, bro. Yeah, the guy's just like chilling, like, well, that sounds like a bad time out there. Guess what, this guy's not gonna put up with whatever's going on out there. I'm just gonna drink some booze. All right, now he's dying, okay. Steal some more shit. Alright, sweet. Oh man, I kinda. Am I a bad person? No, I'm. No, no. I just opened it. Oh. Lame. Guys. Yeah, these folks weren't the greatest in the world. Definitely not the greatest peeps in the world, that's for sure. But I can't get in the store's like inventory. So that's kind of lame, but yeah, Tenpenny Tower. Yeah, I had the key and I unlocked it, but it didn't have anything in there, so I think it was one of those things where it's like, well, you can't just have whatever's in there. So, alright, so Tenpenny Tower's done. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a quick break, I'm going to get a soda, and then when I get back, we're going to do ketchup chips. So I will be right back. Okay, we are back. Alright, got it. Lay's, ketchup, chips. Family size, forma, familia, because la Francais, and it's made in Canada. Check that out. So let's open these bad boys. This bag of chips cost a lot more than, I think it was like $10 off Amazon. Oh, that just straight, that... just straight up smells like ketchup. So, there we go. There we go. Just a... it's a potato chip. Like, I... it's the old Canada. It's a, if it's focusing. There we go. These are fucking awesome. Like, holy shit. These are really fucking good. Hold on, hold on. I gotta go get, like, they're, sorry, yeah, I can't even, like, okay, real time for, an actual review. Oh, they're not salty. They're not, like, a salt, there's not, like, a ton of salt on them. I mean, there's probably salt on them, but not a ton. It's ketchup chips. Like, it is exactly what, right? It's not like overwhelming taste of ketchup. But it's like a sweet, like a sweet ketchup-y potato. Like, it tastes like sweet ketchup, but not like overwhelmingly so. It's not like you are straight up eating ketchup. But kind of at the same time, they're really weird. I'm having a real hard time explaining these. But they are really fucking good. I have not had the all-dressed ruffles. Are those really good? They almost have like a pickly taste on the back end. Almost like how sweet pickles will have that, like, that back of the tongue sweetness. Hold on, I gotta get Mrs. Mannheim on this. I'll be right back. She's gotta get in. This is the vinegar? The vinegar, yeah. That's exactly it. Okay, let's read the ingredients. It's, specially selected potatoes. Specially selected potatoes. Oh, did they bring them? Yeah, these are... I just got them off of, Amazon. I didn't go to the store because I'm a lazy son of a bitch. Nice. Let's see. Seasoning, sugar, salt, milk ingredients, dehydrated vegetables, tomato, garlic, onion, monosodium glutamate, sodium acetate, corn, malted dextrin, acetic acid, flavor, dextrose, malic acid, citric acid, color, spelled with a U, modified cornstarch, spices, vinegar. There you go. And Canada's like 30 minutes away from it. Like, I could go to Canada relatively quickly. Yeah, I gotta get Mrs. Mano's take on these. I'll be right back. That hurt. Static electricity. That was a no from Mrs. Manna. She was just like, nope, nope, nope. Cucumber chips. Sounds pretty good. Yeah, she took one bite and was just like scrunched up nose and all. I bet the kids are gonna love these though. Cause they love themselves some ketchup. Try getting your hands on the spicy ketchup chips. Spicy ketchup chips. Spicy ketchup chips are the real deal, huh? These are really good. Yeah, these are really good. All right. So we got a win here. They're first. Well, not first, but these ketchup chips, they're balling. This is Mana says no. But ketchup chicks. Yeah, but we all know Mrs. Mana's taste can't be that good because she married me. So I don't know if we can trust her. Judgment. Sicker. Alright. That was a good snack. The bag's just kind of looking at me down there being like, hey. Hey. Hey, put me in your mouth. Yeah, it does mean more for this guy.
I'm gonna eat the shit out of him.
Alright, so... I'm gonna see if the girl, the little ones like them. They might like them. The eldest daughter has not met a chip that she doesn't like. She loves all potato chips. So let's see. Excuse me. We finally did that, so let's just continue to the next part of the invisible fence. Let's just keep on going west. Let's put on some walking tunes now. green countryside game. I appreciate it.
Wake up, Wasteland! It's me, Three Dog, bringing you all the music and news your little hearts can handle. Ah, yes, time for the news.
Oh, this is gonna
neutrality,
be
neutrality, baby. That's today's lesson. Stop our own capital counselor. Maybe that vault door leads to Switzerland. Anyway, he's at it again. Boy, children, you are going to love this. Okay, so I told you about James. I told you somebody else crawled out of there too. Right. Well, guess who came to visit old Three Dog at his luxurious studio in beautiful downtown DC?
This guy.
That's right, the other vault dweller. Now, you want to know if it gets better, don't you? Well, hell yes, it gets better. Turns out Vault Dweller number 2 was none other than James's kid. I know, I couldn't make this
shit up. Shit.
Okay,
What the fuck? What the fuck?
Sad.
What the fuck
is that
shit?
You see, the kid is looking for his dad. Looking for James. See, James left Vault 101 without telling the kid why. Now, I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault? Looks that way.
Oh.
So now, maybe James is going to save the world. A better cause than that. But James, if you're listening, your kid's out, man. This is you. So you might want to find him before he gets swallowed up and spit out. And for all you other cats out there listening, if you see the kid from Vault 101 out there, give him a pat on the back and wish him
luck.
Thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog. And you're listening to Galaxy Radio. Blue Radio Free Wasteland. And we're here for you. Up next, we've got a public service announcement. Listen up,
Three
children.
Three Dog. Meow.
For all you guys and gals tempted by the thought of scabbing in the downtown DC ruins, here's a tip. You see, children, the Frankensteins might violently and horrifically rip you to shreds, but only if you're lucky.
Ooh.
According to most of our reports on the super mutants, they actually prefer capturing their victims and hauling them off to God knows where. Consider yourself officially warned. And now, some music.
Yep, the super mutants take people and throw them into vats of forced evolutionary virus. Sup, boys?
I'm as normal as blueberry pie. No more a smart little girl with no heart. I have found me a wonderful guy.
I am in a convention. We have found ourselves a wonderful guy. His name's Strider. Star in my eye. And you will note there's a lump in my throat. Oh, pretty actor. It is wonderful, Strider. I'm as trident as gay. There it is. There it is. Snook! Got it. All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the field, everybody has to go up. The safest distance between two points is a shadowy line. I missed you so much, Elder Calf. That's a lot. Oh! I'm here all week. Yeah, it was dinner. What did you have for dinner? Was it tasty? Was it delicious? Was it nutritious? No. Well then. Mr. Poe's got your back. Ooh! Ooh! What a nice Joey! Yeah, Mr. Poe's got your back. Don't worry.
Hey, nifty America. It's me, your president, John King. Gotcha! Three dog here. How's everyone doing?
We interrupt our regularly scheduled program for
some news.
Neutrality, baby. That's today's lesson. Top our own capital counselor. Maybe let Baldur leave Switzerland.
Anyway, I was super cool until I killed everyone.
Mr. Vault 101 was spotted over in Arafu, where the settlement has been hit pretty hard lately by a marauding gang of riotous ruffians.
What's up?
But it would seem that after 101 made a little solo sojourn into the murky depths of Moresti Station, the attacks stopped. The cherry on top? He emerged a short time later with a lad named Ian West, who presumably had been taken captive in the latest raid.
After the stunt I pulled earlier.
So what happened down there in the stinking, slinking subway tunnels?
Did you get a squeal of fear? I just got a look of, I'm gonna
really
sleep
matter.
With these little guys.
Arafu is quiet once more, thanks to the efforts of the Lone Wanderer from Vault 101. Thanks for listening, children!
I just got a look of Elder being...
When you're listening to Galaxy Radio, we're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you.
Nothing will get
once again
me better than
GNR public service announcement. Listen, kiddos, never forget the importance of periodic weapon maintenance. Rifle, pistol, police baton, I don't care which. If your weapon is falling apart, the only Wasteland asshole it's gonna kill is you. So be smart.
Nice.
Salvage those parts and make repairs whenever you can. And now, some music.
No, I'm gonna move it. No. before it would go off, because I'm like really good at keeping my eye on chat, so I disabled the message on my side who sent it, but I appreciate it. Nothing will get me as good as that the first time.
When you are all
I timed your chat scanning, nice. Because the first time that it will never beat the first time, because the first time I forgot that I enabled sound alerts. Completely forgot that I enabled them. And it scared the absolute shit out of me. Yes! 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 No, not Ron. No, this girl. This girl. Yes, what's her name? Fucking Fallout 4 Nuka World fans are gonna know this lady. Fucking Sierra! Not that one. Sierra. Fucking, yeah, shit.
Daddy, chill.
There. Just chill, Daddy.
Well, Sierra Petrova does the name. Good to see a new face in Girder Shade.
It's her!
I take it you're here to check out my Nuka-Cola collection and take the tour.
Yeah, I am.
I have one of the... No. The best Nuka-Cola collection in the
capital that's in Fallout 4.
Heck, I've won the Nuka-Cola Fan Club Collection Award for the last 10 years in a row. Yep, I'm the president, the recording secretary, and the treasurer.
Crazy.
Once a year, we gather here in Girder Shade to have a cook-off using Nuka-Cola and the recipe. Last year, I went with my poached
Nuka
sauce. Delicious.
Beautiful.
Well, only two right now, me and Ronald.
Yeah.
But membership is open to the... Ronald? Oh, I'm sorry. I figured you met him already. He usually chats with people who enter Girder Shade. He's my neighbor and my protector, as he calls it. Imagine if some he's such a sweetie. You should talk to him.
Diablo Rex, I love that. So you mentioned Taurus
something? I sure did. Want to take it now?
Fuck yeah, I do.
How can you Well, come on then. Let me
Let's turn off the radio. We gotta listen to this. It's a good clip. I did the scared arms and everything.
When Nuka-Cola was invented by John Caleb Braverton in 2044, it quickly became the world's most popular soft drink.
She's way better at giving tours than I am.
The Wonder Drink soon drew a dedicated following, which prompted the Nuka-Cola Corporation to release many promotional items like these. By 2067, a Nuka-Cola machine such as this rare, pristine model could be found on almost every street in America.
Ooh. Ooh. I really didn't want to play that one, but it was going. I wanted to play a different one because Baby Bagel Ham's in the bath, and that's Hey, Babe Eggleham, you deserve it. That's right, girl. You enjoy it. You enjoy that bath. Harry, you go get her a glass of wine. Okay. Bath does sound very nice right now. Okay. Nuka-Cola.
Even in today's crazy world, Nuka-Cola is still the number one choice of refreshment among Armageddon survivors. As promised, here's a little pick-me-up. An ice-cold Nuka-Cola. Just look at the frost on the bottle. So cold.
Oh, wow.
And delicious. Pardon me. I tend to lose myself when I hold on to a Nuka-Cola. Before I get to the little proposition I have for you, let me tell you a little bit about Nuka-Cola Quantum.
Let's just ask.
Well, right before the bombs fell, the good folks at Nuka-Cola developed what they hoped was an improvement on the original formula. Calling it Nuka-Cola Quantum, it was said to have twice the calories, twice the carbohydrates, twice the caffeine, and twice the taste.
Fresh out until tomorrow. Oh. It's So what went wrong? Oh, there you go. Light a candle. Ooh.
Well, the flavor certainly wasn't really the issue. The public was just split on the unique feature of the Quantum's appearance. You see, to make it stand out on store shelves and to give it that extra kick, the formula called for a mild isotope. The effect was a drink that not only boosted your energy, but also glowed with a bright blue light.
Yeah.
Oh no, only ever so mildly. No ill effects were ever recorded. Well, it does have the unique property of making your pee glow.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. That sounds awesome.
Oh no, not at all.
Just good
Nuka-Cola
quality.
Quantum was made under the supervision of the Food and Drug Association. They would never let harmful products end up in stores.
Never. What's your interest?
I love the stuff. I can't get enough of it.
She's an addict.
I thought I was hooked on regular Nuka-Cola, but the Quantum beats it by a long shot. I've got to have more.
Okay, enough with the addict routine.
Can you resist the taste that'll blow up in your face, like Ronald always says? He thinks of the best Nuka-Cola jingles. Anyway, for every bottle you bring me, I'll pay you some caps.
Ooh.
You know, for expenses. But if you're super cool and find, like, enough bottles to fill my Nuka-Cola machine, 30 in all, I got a super secret cool prize for you.
It's a hand job.
Oh, okay. I have a schematic for the Nuka grenade.
Oh, nice.
The only one in the whole Capital Wasteland. Imagine the look on the target's face. So, what do you...
Yeah, cool.
Oh, goody! I can taste the Quantum already.
Nice.
Good luck to you, sweetie.
Oh, thank you. Alright, I got you some Nuka-Cola Quantum. And me from the bath. It's too much. It's too much. I already drank the candle too late.
Yay! I knew I could count on you. I promised to put them to good use.
Sweet. Oh, yeah, sweet. We got some money.
Hey, pal. What were you doing in Sierra's place?
I was checking out her new
Nuka-Cola. That better be all you were checking out. I don't like guys messing with my woman.
I don't know if she's your woman, my man. What do you... Yeah, I'm gonna do this. She's my girl. Take a number. Let's fight this motherfucker.
I think you better calm down and think long and hard about that.
Yeah.
Girdershade
the
is
fuck
my
outta
town.
Here.
You can't just walk in here and tell me you're taking Sierra. I'm gonna be the first one to tap into her goods.
Whoa!
Not you.
Whoa! 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 Fuck this guy.
Born and raised that way, and damn proud of it. Look, I have an offer to give you. You can either stand there, be a pain in the ass, or you can listen to what I have to say.
Nice. So, what's really cool is if you play a Lady Vault Dweller and you have the Black Widow perk, you can make him go get you Nuka-Cola Quantum because you, very subtly say, if you go get me Nuka-Quantum, I'm gonna arrange a three-way with you, me, and Sierra.
I know she's asked you to find her some Nuka-Cola Quantum. Heck, she asks everyone that wanders through here. What I'm proposing is you still look for the drinks, but instead of bringing
the Black Widow perk is pretty awesome.
She'll be so impressed that I got all the
Nuka-Cola
for her.
It's got some great dialogue options.
I pay you the same she was going to pay, and everyone's happy.
Oh, there's tons of sexy sex. Dude, no, you're fucking creep.
Well, look, don't answer me now. Just keep it in mind. If you find some and you've had a change of heart,
yes.
I'll still buy them.
Elder Calf.
I wouldn't bother running back to Sierra
fucking
and warning
sex
her. She
bot.
Won't even understand what
Fisto,
you're talking about.
He.
She may be a hot
for new bacon.
In the smarts department.
Okay, this guy is a fucking dick. I want to kill him. Can I kill him?
Bringing me some quantum. I.
Can I kill him?
You find the soda, I pay up. Life couldn't be simpler.
He doesn't have anything really nice to kill him for. Sex bot. Yeah, it's a straight up sex bot. And you can try it out. It gets weird. I mean, the screen goes to black, but it's still pretty funny. I mean, these games don't show anything, but it's still... It's, thank God. But it's pretty funny. I remember there was like a Fisto master. Bend over and assume the position. I remember there was like a tweet of like someone basically, well, it was on Reddit and it was coming up to the Cyberpunk release and they asked like, could you control like the sexual positions and shit in game? And the developers were like, dude, like get help. Like, you need some, like, yeah, is it Fisto? Okay, I wasn't making that shit up. Yeah, it's fucking ridiculous. It's awesome. That's a giant rad scorpion, y'all. The raggy, rad scorpions were kind of kicking our ass. So we're just gonna kind of cruise right on out here. Oh, yeah. I mean, y'all know that the Brotherhood Outcasts, they're you know that they're probably naming our next Casto. Next cat, Fisto, that's something. That's a family name right there, jeez. You missed ketchup chips, Baby Bagelham. They are a buy. They are a Mr. Manna buy. Mrs. Manna was like, get those away from me. They are disgusting. But yeah, New Vegas. That entire like, hey, find me some prostitutes was pretty next level.
Fuck red scorpions. Fuck this shit, I'm out.
Fuck that shit, I'm out. Woohoo.
Oh.
Fisto, get off my keyboard. God damn it.
Yes! 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 Dunwich Building!
Okay, this is another great call-out. Fallout 4! Fallout 4, that creepy, like, yes. Fisto D's nuts. Sora will be here all week, ladies and gentlemen. Sora. That's Fisto's legal name. This is Fallout 4 also accidentally. That could be the cat's full name. What? Fisto Sora James? That's pretty good. There is reference to this shenanigans in Fallout 4. This is great. Hey, Nuka-Cola. Quantum, sweet. Of course there's ghouls everywhere. Wait, I got the ghoul mask. Sweet! We got the ghoul masks, dude. We should just be able to, like, walk right through here. I saw the tail end of the chips. I heard you call them ketchup chicks. Yes, you did! Yes, you did! I remember. Because Fisto D. Schnutz. Oh, my goodness. Yes! Ketchup chicks. Yes, that would be a great time. Get some ketchup on these chicky poos.
Apocalypse these days. Here's some of the latest news. Okay, it seems Jamie's the settlement personal. Of Great Ditch has gone quiet. Residents haven't come out to trade with the caravanners, and attempts to make contact have been met with silence. So if you're out by Great
Ditch,
look
at this place.
May want to pop
I like
in
the smell.
See what's what.
Gives me the creeps.
Until next time.
Don't want to risk a shot at the food till I know what's in there. Sneaking in tonight.
So this, that guy was whispering. I couldn't really hear him. Fist. But everyone in the know is gonna be like, "What's up, Fisto? She these nuts in the fist? Yeah, nuts." Fitz is a cute name. Nuts in the mouth. In the face. Where am I going? Just put the nuts in the face. Okay. Oh, I fell through a hole. Like, not a good hole. It wasn't moist at all. It was dry. Dry and disappointing. Oh, it wasn't a good hole. Not a fan. There's. Yeah, you don't want a crusty, dusty hole. You want a nice hole. That is a bomb. Maybe I want to go in the hole? Yeah, I went in. I went in the hole. Body parts. Must be going on the right spot because this is... Fisto, get in the hole! Yeah, so... Make Fisto commands. Okay, I did want to go in the... Okay. I wanted to go in the hole. That was crazy. The queen just came in to get the dog. She left that. She was sneaky about it because she didn't want me to like turn the camera around on her. She's like, I'm a secret. My subjects and. She never wants to be on camera. I don't want to read all this stuff, but we have to. We have to, because this is important for Fallout 4 fans. Moment of sales staff. In recognition of an exemplary quarter, Mr. Statham has authorized me to release sales staff early for the holidays. It was no easy task to release a new acoustic board to a market used to conventional built bore drilling systems, but thanks your hard work and rah, 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 acoustic bore drills are setting a new standard in the excavation industry. Thanks to you, many private sales and procurement of government contracts will be in the black for the foreseeable future. Happy holidays now. Go home to your families. All right, right before the bombs fall, 10:23. Unintelligible noise. Notice to user. PegSoft LLC recommends against sustained recordings in a low frequency environment. Okay. Oh, that was probably the nuke. Yeah, the 23rd. I think that's when the bombs fell, right? What the hell was that? Doesn't matter. So this is 2134. Interesting. Alright. My skin, barely any left. Stay close. Qui-Loth, one of us, Qui-Loth is returned. Oops, let's read that again. Qui-Loth, I came back this time. Deep temple, screaming, twisting, no light. Please, that's awesome. So, in Fallout 4, that entire stuff comes to a head. The entire, like, crazy god cult thing. Oh, jeez. Don't want to get too close. You don't want to get too close to them for too long with your zombie mask, or they will sniff you out that you are not a ghoul, and they will be like, yo, there's one thing that we don't appreciate as ghouls, and that's that. Oh, I fell in the hole. And that's ghoul fakers. We don't want ghoul fakers. No, there is a cult that worships a, like, bad divinity that turns out to be, like, totes real. Like, we'll see, like, it's an actual, like, extra, like, dimensional being. It's crazy. Yeah. I must want to go down, then. I don't remember exactly the name of it, but, like, let's listen to Jamie's personal journal. Sharp knife.
Sharp knife to send him to Deep Temple. Play and say my words. Abdul comes again on the feast of the weaker. Feast for the Deep Temple. Born again. Here. Al-Hazared. Yet. Yet.
So the guy turned into a ghoul. So that's why the pillars of the community? I forget what it's called. We will find out in a second. So much easier with the ghoul mask. We are pillars of community. A pillar of a whole. We are the pillars of a whole community. I don't want to go to the Dunwich building. I want to go deeper. I want to go deeper in this hole. Just so goddamn deep in this hole. How can I go deeper? Let me. Yeah. Yeah, not the amphitheater. No, they were that. This is something a little bit more dark and sinister. Like, seriously, supernatural. Like,
how'd you?
Oh, whoa! Fuck that guy. Okay, he was still alive. Like, see this? This obelisk thing? Is there really nothing else in here? There's an area in Fallout 4 that is directly related to this shenanigans. Let me Google Dunwich building really quick. And then we're probably going to, it's pretty late, so I'm just going to call it quits here, and then we're going to raid someone. So Dunwich building, here we go. Let's see. So a strange altar found in the depths of this building may hold the key to discovering more about this previously unknown entity. Unfortunately, because all investigators into, no idea what that means. Notable loot. Let's see, is there anything? So the bobblehead melee weapons is in located in the virulent underchambers on the ground right at the end of the zone. So there is a bobblehead somewhere. Keep our eye out for that. Yeah. I'd have to look into it for Fallout 4. Let me find this bobblehead and then I'll... There it is. We got two bobbleheads. Ladies and germs. Oh, sorry, I'm still on chatting. Let's see here. Yeah, there's in Point Lookout. In Point Lookout, it is related to... There's more stuff in that DLC about this that we can investigate, but when we get to that area, we can discuss this more in detail, but it is some really, really, like, yeah, there's totally, like, supernatural shit going on in this world. So I just saved the game, so let's see if any of our friends are online. And if we can, we can give them a good old raidy poo. Let's see here. Let's see. Oh, hey! I Heart Bears is online. Sweet. Yeah, we're gonna raid I Heart Bears, because we always got to. Yeah, I just want to say thank you, everyone, for hanging out with me and enjoying the tour a little bit. I'm glad that I decided to... go west instead of trying to make the downtown DC area work, because that is definitely a tough place to scavenge around. It's just been kicking my butt. But we got to the Dunwich building. Supernatural things exist. It's kind of a tee up for stuff in the DLC that we're gonna do, that we're gonna play, and Fallout 4 actually has the finale of it. Oh, excuse me. But we are going to raid our good friend. Let's see, he's probably still in chat. He is, sweet. We are gonna raid I Heart Bears? Let's see. I Heart Bears. There we go. I Heart Bears. So we're gonna... There we go. Fisto, let's raid. So yeah, we're gonna send our good friend Bear a raid. Hey, I just want to say appreciate everyone hanging out. Huge shout out to Baby Biggleham and I Am Hardcore Harry for resubbing. I totally appreciate it. Elder Calf, I appreciate your sit down and stand ups. Sora, thank you so much for hanging out and playing lights and music. No, thank you, Stream Daddy. Mr. Poe, thank you for keeping me honest and keeping me standing up and turning me on to Miss Vicky's spicy ketchup chips. Strider, as always, soup night. And everyone else, yeah, just thank you so much for coming in and hanging out, and let's send Bear some love, and I'll see y'all over there.